In this video, I'm going to share with you 12 tips or techniques for greater stability while hand-holding your camera shooting photographs or video. Remember, stability is the key. And many of these tips are related or kind of cross paths, so to speak. They're kind of one and the same, but then not. Tip number one, use as many points of contact as possible. That means two hands, your face, your arms rested against your body. This is not as many points of contact as possible. We're gonna intertwine that with some other tips. Number two, lean or rest your camera against a solid object that is not moving. If you're down low, rest it on a log or a camera bag or a rock, or your knees, rest it on a solid object. Tip number three, keep your hands between your camera and the solid object that you're resting on or leaning against. Tip number four, no chicken wings. Rest your elbows into your body. Tip number five is related to tip number four, no chicken wings, and that is take your left hand and let your camera rest in your hand while your whole arm is resting against your chest. Tip number six, while shooting vertically, everything applies.
Let me just jump in here and say that I don't have any sponsors for my videos or for anything that I do. I personally fund everything that I do. And one way that I do that is through the company that I'm building, Timotheus Enterprises, and my Etsy store. In my Etsy store, I sell products that feature my photography, landscape photography, nature photography, abstract photography, or any other photography that I think might be of interest to others. One of our customers, Jonathan, writes, "I think the cutting board is the centerpiece of our whole kitchen." So folks, jump on over to Timotheus Enterprises Etsy store today. Check out my products, and I'll leave a link in the description below.
The following tips have to do with shooting pictures or video while being active. For instance, climbing, hiking, run and gun type shooting, things like that. And they also relate to your breathing. So tip number seven is regulate your breathing and bring it down. Take a deep breath and let it out. And just keep doing that for a while to regulate your body and to calm it down. Take a deep breath, exhale, nice and slow. Not a lot of fast deep breathing, just a nice, slow, deep breath and exhale. So tip number eight is the tail end of tip number seven. Slow your breathing down, regulate it till it's consistent. Slowly bring it down as quickly as you can, especially if you're running and gunning. You just gotta learn to deep breathe, exhale, deep breathe, exhale, deep breathe, exhale, get it consistent. Tip number nine is don't hold your breath while working on tip number eight. while regulating your breathing and bringing it down to being consistent, if you hold your breath, you restrict the airflow to your blood, which restricts your muscles, which tenses your muscles. It also keeps carbon monoxide in rather than letting carbon monoxide out. Anytime you hold your breath, it is working against you. Tip number 10 is related to tip 8 and tip 9. When you take a deep breath and let it out, at the bottom of your exhale, take your picture. Tip number 11 is minimize the intake of coffee and caffeine. When I was in the Army in photography school, we had long days where we crammed 2 years worth of photography school into 3 months, and we consumed a lot of coffee. And it got to the point where I could not handhold a camera to save my life. I shook so bad. And I knew exactly what the problem was. I backed off the coffee and I could shoot handheld again. So limit the intake of your caffeine in your coffee. Tip number 12. If necessary, bring your ISO a little higher and then bring your shutter speed a little faster so that you minimize camera shake and movement. Number 13, the bonus tip, if you're shooting video, use your body to churn and pan or tilt.